an English champion at the apex of his skill. On a journey started by his father, he finds inspiration in those closest to carry him the furthest. In search of lasting legacy and financial stability for his family. It's sometimes referred to as the sweet science. Yet there will be times when it can be truly brutal. The men who step inside the squared circle have no fear of the destiny that awaits them. They fight for the chance of a better future, the desire to engage in violent combat. Shaquan Pitters fights for these exact reasons. Having joined the world of professional boxing at the age of 27, Shaquan has amassed a 13-fight undefeated record. This is Boxing Kings, the tale of Shaquan Pitters. Commonly referred to as the second city of the United Kingdom, Birmingham is home to almost 3 million people. Shaquan was raised in the Ward End area of Birmingham.
It was just me looking up to my dad and my brothers, my older brothers. You know, I started obviously playing football, started going to the gym from a young age. My dad installed that discipline in me and my brothers from a very young age. You know, our whole family in saying that, even my mum, like, we're always on that whole cultural training thing. We religiously get up like three, four times in the week, 4 in the morning, go for runs together as a family, and it's crazy to the outside people, you know. But I think it's made me who I am today, you know, like, in the sense where I'm a strong believer, being disciplined and dedicating myself to my craft and anything I do.
Shaquan's love for football diverted him away from boxing, as he spent his teenage years playing football for West Bromwich Albion.
Where I've won each one from, obviously that's when I was playing football. I guess that's when I more or less started back amateur boxing, 2012. Zach written off, yeah. 2012 started it. I just leave all these trophies at my mum's. You know, I've never been the person who's, it sounds bad, I've never been interested in trophies.
This is a parents player, 1998.
I first walked into a team called Romulus Boys at the age of 6. It was around that age of 6, 5, when I more or less not far after starting to walk. Started kicking football there, just going practices, training. And it's just something I just took on very quickly, football. I enjoyed the sport. So I carried on playing anyway for Romulus, where I then got scouted for West Bromwich Albion, playing there for 5 years. As well as doing the football, I was mixing it up with the boxing, in the sense where my dad was never going to let me go to take that step to be a boxer. I had to take that step now in my adult years, where I can make that decision for myself. He didn't want me to. Every time I quit, you know, I wanted to do it. He was like, nah, you just want to stick at football. Got released from West Brom, and I was just found myself into a path where I was just working.
Having never reached the heights of footballing success, Shaquan decided to revert back to plan A.
So I just thought, you know, for me, I was at a stage in my life where I was just doing the basic, just working. I thought, you know what, I need to get myself back in the gym. I need to get myself back doing something I love. And obviously I've kind of fell out at that point, the love with football. I knew where a boxing gym was. I went down there and I decided to, you know, I looked in it because it's glass windows. I was questioning myself, thinking, you know what, should I go in, should I not? Then a guy came out who was actually a fighter there himself, an amateur boxer called Romain, NQ. He came out and he was just like, oh yeah man, you know, this is the gym, it's good, this, that. And then I thought, oh yeah, I'll probably come back tomorrow. And that's what it said. He was like, nah, come on man, come in. Let's go and see the coach. I introduced to the coach. So I was like, cool. Went and seen the coach. Asked me about my experience, spoke about my dad fighting and so on. I had a little brief conversation. His name's Paddy Farrell, he's my first amateur coach. He said, yeah, all right, cool, come back in the gym.
At the age of 22, Pitters began his quest back into boxing, fighting in the amateur ranks.
I was 22 years old when I walked into that gym and decided, okay, look, I'm gonna give boxing a proper shout. Now, for some people, that's late. Some people, that's still early. But for me, I think it was just the perfect timing.
He turned professional in 2017, trained by father and son duo, Paul and Louis Kunian.
I mean, me and Louis around, like, obviously, we're into the same things and so on. So it's, and same with Sally, man, we all got the comedy in between us, the bants is just mad.
How much you owe me, mate?
Just 250 quid plus VAT.
Obviously, we've got a good friendship and we like a family as well. I mean, oftentimes, sometimes I'm late for things. They're trying to tell me, like, you know, be somewhere half an hour earlier. And I know he's going to be half an hour later, and I'm still probably late, but he has a fuss and a moan about that.
You're a fucking knob. Whoever's watching this is a knob. He's a late bastard. Fucking, what are we? 17 minutes late. Turn around.
He came to us as an amateur. 81 kilos as an amateur, and he boxed a couple of years as an amateur. Didn't really take it seriously. He was always like missing training sessions, overweight, never lived the life. We got him to the semi-finals of the novices. What I was really impressed with is that, because he started off a cruiserweight, and he was making it, you know, way too easy. He was underweight. You know, making it a bit too easy, and like we said to him, we said, we know he's got the height to be heavyweight, but we said, like, you know, we think he should drop down to light heavyweight. And when he dropped down to light heavyweight, he started dropping his sparring partners and his opponents.
After cruising to a 7-fight undefeated streak, Shacken was offered a life-changing opportunity in November of 2018. He entered the Ultimate Boxer Light Heavyweight Tournament, in which 8 fighters face off against each other on the same night. Having cruised through to the final with 2 comprehensive wins, Shacken outboxed renowned puncher Dex Spellman in the final to win himself the 16,000-pound prize fund. Little did they know that their paths would cross one more time. Brothers Anwar and Dre both played key roles in getting Shacken to where he is today. No fighting man is complete without a strong woman by his side. Shacken has 2, his partner, Timia, and 4-year-old daughter, Leilani.
The only reason I decided to turn pro was because, like I said, the sake of my daughter. I had my daughter, I was just thinking about the life I could give her. I knew I was always good at boxing from a young age. People said I was good. I knew I was good at it. So I just thought with her behind me and with her in my mind, that I'd go on to do great things in boxing. A grilla, chicken and things. This for the rice though. This is my secret ingredient. I like to bang it in the rice just to flavour it a bit. Two of these. And a whole grain. Not a lot of people know about this. I like to cook though, man. It's like all-purpose seasoning. Yeah. A little hidden one as well. Like, a lot of people don't do this, yeah, but a little bit of fish seasoning doesn't harm it on the chicken. Gives it that next little twang, little flavour. You've got to really get your hands in there. Obviously, wash your hands. Get your hands in there. I normally bang a bit of onion in there as well, but you know, then a little secret little. It's a little light sprinkle just to enhance. Boom. This is your healthy dish. Minus the rice. It still is healthy. I had to come down with me. There we go. So that was sitting there. Chef on us on this.
Are you?
Yeah.
You're not really.
I am chef on Sundays, you know. Be chill, man. It's Netflix these days, isn't it?
Yeah, when you're in training camp, mm-hmm. It's a bit more boring if you're not going them out.
Well, when I'm in training camp, she does join in. Like,
going gym together, go gym swimming together.
Swimming. Go swimming and that, so yeah. It's a good look.
March 2019. The venue is the Holt Suite within the Aston Villa football ground. A large crowd is gathered to watch a Midlands area title fight between two local fighters. While awaiting news of a potential first title fight, Shaq and Pitters took this opportunity to fight in a scheduled six-round bout. However, his Hungarian opponent had other plans. Shaqin stopped him in the first round. Shaqin's family has gathered at a local Japanese restaurant for a very special occasion. It's the fourth birthday of his daughter, Leilani. One notable arrival is Shaqin's older brother, Anwar, who has just returned from serving in the armed forces.
When I was in the army, that's when he started doing boxing. And I feel that he's probably wanting to pick up the Pitters legacy of boxing, you know. Pitters legacy, the boxing runs in our family.
And my mum's obviously Jamaican. She was born in Sablemar, grew up in Kingston. My dad's family is all on the American side, so my grandma lives in America. My older brother obviously lives in America and all that with his family. I visit both places, man. I can't decide and I can't tell you which place I like best or whatever, because I have good times in both countries. But I'm proud of my heritage. I'm proud of my, you know, what it is.
It's September 2019. A venue labeled by fans as the Mecca of boxing stages an English light heavyweight title fight. Shaken Pitters has his first opportunity to win a boxing title. In the opposite corner is old rival Dex Spellman. It's fight day. The team gathers at the hotel for their final meal before battle.
Yeah, I think Dex is very strong-willed. He's strong-minded, he's coach and that, man. Like, we've got this resilience in them. So I think it's, for me beating him, like the ultimate boxer, you always want to avenge that loss. It's just the character of Dex, you know. And I think he basically put it on me to say, look, you know, we want to defend with you against you. So I was like, all right, well, I'm not going to turn down that opportunity, you know. It's a belt at the same time, and I know where that belt can lead me to, which is to the British and bigger things. So we gladly accepted that.
You know, I love to drive to like my own event and drive myself. It's just another day, isn't it? I just drive to the event.
Unusual to some, Shaken drives himself to the venue. A quick call with his daughter before he shuts himself out from the outside world.
Hey. I'm not gonna choose this man, my daughter. First time on tour. Hey Lee. You okay?
Hey.
You're not gonna wake up for me? Huh?
Hey.
You can give me a kiss. Give me a kiss. Take it, I'll take that.
She's gonna be watching you anyway.
Yeah, that's cool. Okay, then Lee, love you.
Final instructions are passed to Pitters as he makes his way to the ring. Shaken immediately takes control, beating his opponent with fast combinations. The tide then turns. As Pitters is hurt, Spellman comes back with powerful hooks. The crowd at the famous York Hall erupts as the fight turns into an end-to-end war. After sustaining the best Spellman has to offer, Shaken takes over and appears to outbox Spellman in the second half of the fight. He captures his first boxing title, and with it, the respect and recognition of the boxing fans. The fight was later awarded the Midlands Area Fight of the Year by the British Boxing Board.
Well, I think they probably thought at the time that I wouldn't be able to have the rounds with me, and with it being more distance, you know, that he's got more of a chance of, you know, either stopping me or, you know, or me tiring out or whatever it may have been, but obviously it wasn't the case. But I had that opportunity, and he made his voluntary defense against me, fair play to them. Because I always say he could have picked someone easier or whatever it may have been, but he made his voluntary defense against me and I took it with both hands. People only see your hands raised. They don't see the sacrifices you've been through to get there, you know, the bad sessions you may have had, the injuries you may have come through, the, you know, just everything, the hard training, the blood, sweat and tears, whatever, you know, people don't see that, people just see the good bit. So for me, it was more of a relief because I knew it was my first solid camp for a 10 round fight. I've never had a solid camp that solid, so intense and new. It was just a great feeling and a great relief, great, all that hard work wasn't in vain. It's all, you know, it's just a bit, I can't describe it, it's just a good feeling.
Don't worry about that.
How did you not get Mark on him? That's what I was.
Let me get one with Declan.
I'm a serious man, bro.
Commend him, I've got nothing bad to say about him today. He's always
come up,
you know what I mean? Thanks very much, man. Appreciate it. No, you always come up.
I get a bit worked up sometimes.
Nah, listen, mate, it's a part of the sport. Yeah. Come on, man.
It's your first turn round against a tough man who's knocked out 8, dropped 11, or who can punch. Oh, it showed what a great chin he's got, because some of them shots he didn't even see coming and his recuperation was like that. I'm so proud of him. This is the kid who couldn't win the novices as an amateur. You know what I mean? Novices under 10s as an amateur. Now he's English champion as a pro because of the hard work he puts in and he listens, you know what I mean? He listens. I had to give him a couple of tellings off in the corner. You know what I mean? Me and Louis and John had to give him a couple of words. He listened and done it, you know what I mean? And he enjoyed it. He loved the experience and now he's English champion. You know what I mean? Just starting for him. Over the moon for him, over the moon.
Now he's the champion, he's going to have a target on his back and he's going to have to improve, you know what I mean? That, them shots what he took from Spellman in there would have stopped a lot of people. You know, he shouldn't be too hard on himself. I'm just happy we got the win, we got the belt and we move up forward and it was a great fight for the fans.
The other guy was tough as well, so it was my brother's test, 10 rounds, and he's done it. Everyone was questioning his 10 rounds and that. But you know, he's been all right, man, otherwise. Good fight, man.
It was very nerve-wracking. Normally people ask me how is the fight or how I feel, and I see him fighting and always like, I don't really know, I feel fine because he never really get hit by anyone. But this was a really tough fight. So yeah, I was very nervous. I lost my voice, I was just screaming the whole time.
As the dust settles from his latest victory, Shacken takes his mind off boxing. Every Sunday, he attends the local park to support Power Football Club, a football team put together by his childhood friends.
Here at Moor Lane, a place where I used to play football myself as well when I was younger. I used to play for a team called Romulus, but there's a team who I sponsor here called Power FC. It's a Sunday league team, consists of many of my friends, my mates. So they've got a game today against Stallions. Tough game, but they're a good side, so I'm sure they come through. So this is where we're here now. It's part of my Sunday regime, away from boxing. This is as close as I get back to football as I can be, really. Just back and giving back to Power and supporting them as they support me.
The game.
This week, Power loses to local rivals in a closely contested match.
He's dropping on the bar.
No, it never. Come on the floor and he hit it up. He was on the line. He tried to control it on the line.
You're playing the game. I'm watching. Remember, I'm not saying about the performance. I'm talking about the manager. Go. We're watching. Come across the floor. And what he's doing? He's trying to shoot.
Yeah, but if we're at the ball, we're all watching.
But you know what? You're watching.
Fucking another day.
Win, lose, or draw, I'm there, man. I'm there to offer my half in hand, my support, because like I said, a lot of them are my friends anyway. A lot of them are my good friends who I go way back with from school, college days, so what better than to support them as they support me.
Another chapter awaits Shacken, as news of him becoming the mandatory challenger for the British title comes out. He must now face fellow Brit Chad Sugden. While prediction in war can be measured by numbers, warriors are measured by the spirit within their hearts. For them, there is no measure. But to compare success against the fulfillment of their own talent. On March 28th, Shaq and Pitters challenges for the most prestigious prize on these shores, the British light heavyweight title.
Out in the streets, they call it murder. Welcome to Jam Rock Camp, where them thugs them camp on. We to palm that weed in a van back. It in a your handbag, your knapsack. It in a your backpack. The smell I give your girlfriend contact. Somebody not notice. Them only come around like tourists on a beach with a few club sodas. Bedtime stories. Them pose like them I'm Jack Norris. Them don't know that real hardcore. Cause sundowns are not back to. Them thugs them I do what them got to. And don't think twice to shot you. Don't make them spot you. Unless you carry guns, I like to. A bear tough thing come at you. Entrenched on man, laugh off and block off traffic. Then them wheels and pop off and them start clapping. With a bin filed and in it a bit drop it. Police come in a jeep and them can't stop it. Some say them a player boy rabbit. Babylon I get dropped like a bad habit. So nobody post up if you don't have it. Rastafari's dance alone. Welcome to Jah Rock. Out in the streets, they call it murder. Welcome to Jam Down. Poor people are dead at random. Political violence scandal. Pure ghost and phantom. Then you can get
back. When I'm, listen, when I'm older and I'm sitting down and I know that I've done all I can as a man, as a dad, to support her career path. Because that's in essence, that's what I do. I dedicate my career, my life to my daughter. So if I can do everything right by her to make her not have to, how can I say it, like, you know, make wrong decisions or be denied of anything she wants to do in her studies, then I can sit back and smile and know I've done something good.
You have been watching a Boxing King Media presentation. Please subscribe and follow us on all our social media channels.